Plant reproduction comes in two types, sexual and asexual. Sexual reproduction is similar to human reproduction, in which male pollen and female ovarian germ cells fuse into a new organism that inherits the genes of both parents. Asexual reproduction involves vegetative reproduction through stems, roots, and leaves. Essentially, the parent plant regenerates itself by using a part of itself. Both sexual and asexual reproduction methods have their own advantages. In sexual reproduction, the newly formed plant contains a combination of genes, giving it an advantage in adapting to changing environments. Asexual reproduction is faster, and perhaps the only way of reproducing in species that do not bear flowers. A flower consists of four whorls or parts, a calyx, corolla, andrecium, and gynoecium. The andrecium contains a bundle of stamens composed of a tube called a filament and a swollen end called the anther. The anther contains pollen grains. Once matured, the pollen grains burst out to reach the female reproductive part of the flower. The gynoecium contains the pistil, which is composed of the tube that reaches the ovary. The swollen tip of the style is the stigma, which receives the pollen grains. In the ovary, there are the ovules, which turn into seeds. Unisexual or monosexual flowers contain either of the reproductive parts, stamen or pistil. The same plant can have both male and female unisexual flowers. Bisexual or complete flowers contain both the male and the female gametes. The transfer of pollen from the anther to the stigma of the flower is called pollination. During fertilization, the male and female germ cells of the pollen unite to form a zygote. A zygote then transforms into an embryo, which eventually becomes a seed. The seed then germinates into a new plant. Birds, insects, animals, water, and wind are all called agents of pollination, as they help the plants reproduce. Wind and water carry the pollen grains to other plants. Birds and insects are attracted to the color and scent of the flower. As they flit from one flower to another, pollen grains get stuck in their bodies and are then transported to other flowers. Animals and birds eat the subsequent fruit and scatter the seeds, or the seeds remain undigested and are thus excreted from their body in full form. Asexual reproduction is how we can clone the best plant of a species. Vegetative propagation is a form of reproduction using the leaves, stems, or roots of the parent plant. Sweet potatoes, dahlias, and asparagus are all reproduced through tuberous roots. The roots of such plants contain buds that can form leaf shoots under favorable conditions. Bryophyllum reproduces through leaf margins. If a leaf falls on damp soil, it can give rise to a new plant. Runners like strawberries reproduce through stems. Plants such as cacti reproduce when a part becomes detached from the parent plant. The detached part then starts a life of its own. New plants produced by vegetative propagation are an exact copy of their parent plants. Sexual and asexual reproduction are different adaptations that plants have used to perpetuate their species, even in adverse conditions. Plants with flowers use sexual reproduction by attracting various agents of pollination. Plants without flowers rely on stems, leaves, and roots that form buds and produce identical copies.